So when it comes to this concept of EMF equation of a transformer, okay, now as we know, it's working principle. Okay, as we just interacted, saying that whenever an alternating voltage is applied on the primary winding, an alternating current is going to flow through this winding, which produces an alternating flux. So this alternating flux, when it links with this coil, so at that time it produces an self-induced EMF. So when this part of this flux, when it links to the secondary winding, so at that time it produces an EMF, which is called as a mutually induced EMF, wherein this mutually induced EMF is also alternating in nature. And hence the current I2 is also alternating. So now, as we know that E1, what is E1? A self-induced EMF. It is being given by E1 is equals to minus N1 d phi by dt. So let me call this as equation 1. Okay, where E1 is nothing but a self-induced EMF. This negative sign is in accordance with stating that the induced EMF will be having a polarity in a phase opposition with respect to the applied voltage. I simply mean to say, saying that if this is my applied voltage, a supply voltage V, or V1, whatever you are going to call, my induced voltage, that is E1, will be having a phase such that it is in phase opposition to the supply voltage. So this is my E1. So this is what your negative sign is saying. Saying that if your supply voltage is having a positive swing, then your induced EMF will be having a negative swing. Okay. If your supply voltage goes negative, then your induced EMF will be having a positive swing. This is in accordance with your Lenz law. So this negative sign is in accordance with the Lenz law, which just says that the induced EMF will be in phase opposition to the supply voltage. Okay. Now, so I know that E1 is being given by minus N1 d phi by dt, a rate of change of flux. Now, what is that I need to understand over here is, since applied voltage is alternating, the current that flows through this circuit is also alternating, right? Now, since this current is also alternating, what about the flux? The flux also has to be alternating in nature. Then the equation for the flux is being given by phi is equals to phi m sine omega t. Phi is equals to phi m sine omega t. Okay, now what I need to do over here is I have to just substitute the value of phi into this equation. I have to just substitute the value of phi in this equation. So my E1 will be equals to minus N1 d by dt of phi, where phi is being defined as phi m sine omega t. Then I can write this equation even as minus N1 as it is d by dt of phi m. What is phi m? It is a maximum flux. What is phi m? It's a maximum flux. So this phi m is treated as a constant. So I'll take this constant term outside. So I'll get phi m outside. What is left out now? D by dt of sine omega t. So differentiation of sine is what? Cos omega t. Remember, you are differentiating with respect to t, but your function is cos omega t. Sorry, your function is omega t. Understanding? So now d by dt of sine omega t is what? D by dt of sine omega t is cos omega t into differentiation of omega t is omega. differentiation of omega t is omega. Understanding? So I'll be getting an equation saying that E1 is equals to minus this omega, I'll write it first, omega into N1 into phi n cos omega t. Okay, what is this omega? It's an angular frequency. It's known to me. Omega is nothing but an angular frequency, which is known to me. So I can write this equation as minus, this omega can be written as 2 pi f n1 into phi m into cos omega t as it is. Now, if you see this equation, I want maximum value of this induced EMF. I can simply say that I want to know what is my EM. I want to know what is my EM, a maximum value of induced EMF or primary induced EMF. When my EM can be maximum? Any thoughts? Any ideas? You just observe this equation. I want my E1 to be max. Then I can call it as EM. I can just make a transition from E1 to EM. When this equation goes to maximum value? Yes? Okay, when the angle is zero. Spurti, your thought is right, but you have to think in a proper aspect. Now you see here, if you make your angle zero, what happens? Cos zero. Yes? What happens here? Yes, good. Vinay Gamma going in a proper manner. You want your equation to be maximum. Whenever this, or my basic requirement is my E1 should be maximum. So this E1 will be maximum only when this function becomes 1. This function becomes 1. Understanding? So when cos omega t becomes 1. So when the cos omega t becomes 1, my equation can be written as EM is equals to minus 2 pi f n1, right? Am I right? Minus 2 pi f n1, left out is phi m. Left out is phi m. Understanding? Is it clear? So this is my equation. EM is equals to minus 2 pi f n1 into phi m. So this is the equation for a EMF equation of a transformer. A same thing can be proved. If I'm considering the case on the secondary. This I can still resolve it. This is not a final expression. Still I need to resolve it. Now, from this equation, I can simply say that n1 is number of number of turns on the primary. Phi m is nothing but the maximum flux. Now, after computing this EM, I want to know what is the RMS value of the induced EMF. So, how to get the RMS value? So, in order to get the RMS value, so ERMS, which I want it to be a maximum value, which will be equal to EM divided by root 2. So whatever I'm getting, so this equation has to be divided by root 2. So in that case, what I'll be getting? So ERMS, which is a maximum value, it is being given by minus, what I'll be getting this? 2 pi f n1 into pi m divided by root 2. Okay, so I know pi is nothing but 3.142, 2 is a constant. So if I take the scaling factor of this, what's the equation I'll be getting? Yes? Give me the value of this. 2 pi divided by root 2. 2 pi divided by root 2. Yes, you'll be getting it as 4.44. Yes or no? So 2 into 3.42 divided by root 2. You'll be getting it as 4.44 into F phi m F n1 into the phi m. Okay? So if at all, if they ask you what is the EMF equation of a transformer, people should be able to say that EMF equation of a transformer is being given by 4.44 F phi m into n1. F phi m into n1. So this is the EMF induced on the primary. Based on this, is it possible by you people to develop the equation for what is the EMF on the secondary? If you want to give the equation for EMF on the secondary, what will be your equation? Yes, if you want to develop your EMF on secondary, what changes you have to do in your equation? Again, you have to do it right from beginning, or just you can say that similarly, what might be your equation for E2? Yes? What will be the equation for your E2? Yes, so I need to just replace this N1 by N2, because N1 is number of turns on the primary. So hence I am getting E1. What is the amount of EMF induced on the primary side? Right? Now, in order to identify what is the EMF which is being induced on the secondary, what I need to do, I need to just replace N1 by N2. So 4.44 F phi m into N2. So you may be thinking, sir, where did that minus sign went? Let me say you, as it is an induced EMF, so this induced EMF has to be in phase opposition to the supply voltage. So this negative sign what we were defining over here, this was in just accordance with the Lenz law, saying that this EMF induced will be in the phase opposition with the applied voltage. So either you can write this default, whenever you say it's a induced EMF, it default meaning that this term is negative. So you did not show it explicitly. You did not show it explicitly. So from now on, if someone asks you what is the EMF equation for a transformer in general, then in that case you can say that EMF equation of a transformer is being given by 4.44 F phi m into n. If I take this as n1, then this becomes the induced EMF on the primary side. If I consider it as N2, then it becomes the induced EMF on secondary side. So this equation you have to remember, it is very, very important equation, and this derivation is also one of the important derivation from the VTU examination perspective. Okay, is it clear to you? Yes, any doubts? Any doubts?